Oh my freaking god, that's insane. What is this hellish creature? Believe it or not, but these are caterpillars. The freakiest caterpillars on the planet, in fact. Wow. These are the caterpillars of the so-called lobster moth or Staurolepis vagi. And among the caterpillar kingdom, their appearance is certainly odd and unique. Let me tell you more about them. After seeing their weird body shape, one may wonder, what is the function of having such long legs? Clearly, it's inconvenient for these caterpillars to walk using such long legs. The answer to that is that the legs clearly have a defensive function. Sometimes the caterpillars will disturb each other. They don't really tolerate each other's presence that well. And what you will see is they will assume a threat pose and they will kind of lash out at each other using their legs. And in those situations, it's pretty clear that the legs on this species do have a defensive purpose. Despite the fact that it makes walking for them probably a little bit harder than for the average caterpillar, they get in the way. Staurolepis vagi occurs from northern Spain through Europe and temperate Asia to Japan. It is a Palearctic realm species with a wide distribution from Europe to Asia. Caterpillars love to eat oak tree, willow, hazel, cherry, but their main host plant by far is beech tree. So why do they have these bizarre legs? Well, despite the fact it inconveniences them when they are walking around, they offer some benefits as well. Namely the benefit of looking really threatening and scary, and being able to push away predators. When disturbed, the caterpillars will often use their long legs to lash at a perceived threat. And there you have it. In comparison to the caterpillars, the moths don't look that crazy, although they do have an interesting wing shape and furry appearance. The moths cannot feed and live for about a week, only to die after mating and laying eggs. The species has mostly one generation a year, and the moths can be found from April to August. In some occasions they can have a second generation as well, or at least they do in the captivity, because I was able to produce two generations of them without any sort of hibernation. Breeding this species is not difficult. However, it can be difficult to obtain them. Despite the fact that this species is relatively common in the wild, females reportedly rarely come to light, and it's the females who lay eggs. The caterpillars also live a hidden lifestyle, sometimes high in the trees, and they are well camouflaged, believe it or not. So breeding material, despite the fact that they are not a rare species, can be hard to come by. So I'm lucky to raise them in captivity. Wow! I hope you guys liked it. And if you guys want to see more epic freaks of nature, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell. In 7 years' time, I have made over 1,000 videos. Wow, it just pooped. Over 1,000 videos about butterflies, moths, and various other insects. It's also possible to find me on Instagram and on the crowdfunding platform Patreon, because my YouTube channel is demonetized. Hope to see you guys in the next episode. Bye bye. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it and saw something new and scary and crazy.